I'm Nico, and I'm a PhD student in the Molecule, Cells, and Organisms program at Harvard University. In this video, I'll show you how to perform a Western plot. The purpose of a Western plot is to specifically look at a single protein and visualize it on a camera. The steps included in running a Western plot are a protein shell, which can be found in a different video, but using the product of this protein shell, the proteins themselves are transferred onto a membrane. A primary antibody is added to the membrane to specifically bind to your protein of interest. A secondary antibody binds the first antibody, and this secondary antibody usually contains some sort of fluorophore, which we are then able to see when placing everything into a camera system. To run a Western plot, the first step after running the protein shell is to assemble the Western sandwich. The Western sandwich consists of three sheets of Wattman paper, the gel, a nitrocellulose membrane, and three more pieces of Wattman paper assembled in this transfer chamber. An important thing is to not touch these with your fingers, so I'll use tweezers. I'm pre-soaking everything in transfer buffer first, and that just helps the transfer occur more smoothly later on. So, second piece of Wattman paper, and the third piece of Wattman paper. Quickly going to smooth this out to make sure there are no air bubbles. Then using a razor blade, I will disassemble the gel cassette. I like to run the razor blades along the sides here to help loosen it from the glass plate. Carefully pull it out. So give it a quick dunk in the transfer buffer and then transfer it onto the sandwich. And if needed, you can use your fingers to carefully smooth it out a little bit. Next up is the nitrocellulose membrane that usually comes protected within a few other sheets of paper. Make sure to remove those first, otherwise the transfer will not work. Again, pre-soak it and add it on top of the gel. And to finish it off, three more pieces of Wattman paper. The main purpose of the Wattman paper is to protect the entire sandwich from the current going through and to help ensure that the current goes through evenly. Okay, now that it's all assembled, I'm going to flatten everything again to make sure all air bubbles are out. Put the lid on. The red electrode is already connected. The black one still needs to be connected. And this is going to run at a constant 200 milliamperes for about 1 hour. This Western has now been transferring for about 1.5 hours, which means it's time to stop it. You can disconnect the leads, disassemble the box, and carefully take off the membrane. Looking at the membrane here, I can see the ladder markings transferred over onto it, which means the overall transfer step worked well. The next step is for me to put this membrane into this box right here, and I'm going to add a 5% milk solution on top of it. And this milk solution contains some proteins which will bind to any part of the membrane that does not yet have proteins attached to it. This will prevent non-specific binding from the antibodies later on. Okay, close it up. I place it on the shaker, turn it on, and this now sits here for about 1 hour. After blocking for 1 hour, it's time to add the primary antibody. First, I take this back off of the shaker. Being careful to keep the membrane inside the chamber, I dump off the 5% milk solution I added earlier. And now I prepare the primary antibody. I have primary antibody here that I've been storing on ice. And I have 10 milliliters of milk solution here into which I will add the primary antibody. This particular antibody gets added in a 1 to 1,000 dilution, which means that if I have 10 milliliters here, I add 10 microliters of antibody. Take 10 microliters, and I put this back on ice. Add the antibody into the milk solution. Quickly invert it to make sure it's mixed. Add it on top of the membrane. And start rocking it again. This primary antibody incubation step can be done in one of two ways. It can either be left at room temperature for about 1 hour, or it can be placed into a cold room and left overnight to come back to the next morning. The primary antibody has now been incubating for 1 hour. So I will turn this off, remove it, again dump off the supernatant. Certain primary antibodies, you can keep them and reuse them. This particular one, you can only use once, which is why I dumped it off. Prior to adding the secondary antibody, the membrane needs to be washed. We do this with a TBS T buffer. Just add a little bit on top, just enough to cover the membrane. And add it back on the rocker for 5 minutes. And this washing step gets repeated 2 more times after this for a total of 3 washes at 5 minutes each. The third wash is now complete, which means you take the membrane off 1 more time. As before, dump the liquid into the liquid vase. And now it's time to add the secondary antibody. This, like the primary antibody, gets added into a milk solution. However, the secondary antibody is only required at a dilution of 1 to 10,000, which means into 10 milliliters, I add 1 microliter of antibody. Pipette it into here. Quickly invert it to make sure it's mixed. Add on top of the membrane and place back on the rocker for about 1 hour. The secondary antibody has now been sitting on here for 1 hour, which means it is also done. Dump off the antibody. And just like after the primary antibody, there will be 3 wash steps here. Again, I cover the membrane in enough TBST to make sure all of it is covered. Close up the box, place it on here, turn it on, and again, this will happen for a total of 3 washes at 5 minutes each. This is the end of the third wash after adding the secondary antibody, which means all of the antibody steps are now done, all of the wash steps are now done. Going to dump the liquid 1 more time, and we can now take the membrane to the imager and see what we have. Now the final step of the Western blot. We are here at the imaging machine, which allows us to image our protein of interest. Remember, we ran the gel and we transferred the proteins onto the membrane, added a primary antibody on top of that, which recognized our specific protein, and we added a secondary antibody, which specifically recognized the primary antibody. What I didn't mention at the time was that the secondary antibody contains a fluorophore, and using this machine, we are able to shine a light at the fluorophore, which then emits another light, and this machine is able to detect that and give us a nice graphical output of our protein of interest. So we'll take our membrane, again using the tweezers, make sure to place it on the imager upside down so that our protein side is facing the bottom. Close the lid and click acquire. Okay, and here's our final image of the Western blot. we see our protein ladder nicely showing up over here, and these four lanes now show the band that we couldn't see before. This right here is our protein of interest, which looks very nice in the first three lanes, maybe a little bit of degradation in lane four, but it's still there. I'm happy with this Western blot.